Welcome to Intermediate Level English Language Arts. Hi guys, we're going to be discussing now the last topic for week 3. This last topic is writing a description. Okay, now let us go through the different objectives. We only have one main objective here: to be able to use writing a description to apply the knowledge of conjunctions. Okay, so guys, I will not anymore introduce what the description is or a descriptive paragraph is. We've already discussed this when you were last quarter, okay, third quarter. But just to give you a very, very, very quick review of what it is, again, a descriptive or writing a description is basically you writing a composition, a written work with a lot of descriptions, describing one thing, one animal, one place, one object, one idea, one person can be as well. That is writing a description. Here, in your pre-write, you're going to do that again. Okay. You will first think of anything that gets your interest. It could be an animal, it could be a place, it could be an object, it could be an idea, anything that catches your interest. What will you do? You will write 3 sentences about it using 3 different subordinating conjunctions. What are subordinating conjunctions? You could just go back, right, and look at the video on the different conjunctions. There are around 50. Use 3 and in different sentences, right? And you will also use 2 sentences or write 2 sentences about it using 2 different coordinating conjunctions. Okay? What are your coordinating conjunctions again? Remember, fanboys. For and nor. But or yet so. And the last one, use 1 sentence about it using any correlative conjunction. There are many. Either or, neither or, but and, right? Stuff like that. Use these different sentences when you write your description. Again, 3 different subordinating conjunctions, 2 different coordinating conjunctions, and 1 correlative conjunction. That's for your pre-write. And when you're done with that, complete the sentences to make it a paragraph, right? So make sure that you construct your paragraphs already using the sentences that you've listed down. Write 1 to 3 paragraphs about your chosen topic. Be as descriptive about it. Take note, in writing a description, you have to include the things that you've seen or heard or smelled or felt or tasted or even the things that you've thought about. Be descriptive. Okay? That's the key word here. Be descriptive. When you're done with that, go to your revise. In the revise, go through these different questions. Did I use 3 subordinating conjunctions, 2 coordinating conjunctions, and 1 correlative conjunction? Are all my relevant details included? Am I able to use the correct conjunctions? Do I still need to add more details? Or are there parts that I have to delete? Do my subjects and verbs agree? Make sure that all of them are yes first before you move on to the next part. Because if there's anything that's no, then make the necessary changes. When you're done with that, go to your edit. Check for grammar, spelling, indention, and punctuation mark errors. This is a very important step. And then, once you're done with that, go to your publish. In your publish, write the description of a memorable place or a memorable item or anything, right, that caught your attention. Okay? Write it where? In your notebooks. So the one that you've written down or the one that you've prepared in your draft, right? Write it in your notebooks or pad papers. Write 1 to 3 paragraphs about it, right? Using 3 subordinating conjunctions, 2 coordinating conjunctions, and 1 correlative conjunction. Write writing a description too, because it's the second time that you have ever done it. So writing a description too as the activity title and give it a title and then send it online. All right? And that pretty much ends our topic on writing a description.